When I was in third grade, I did not know how to read. And I don't want them to have the struggle that I had. I don't. If the goal is to have people thrive, they should also be given tools to help them. And I think that it starts with data. Every day in class, we have a data meeting when you're giving them that individual feedback. The personalized learning is very strong. They'll go to a writing workstation where they'll work on a skill based on the previous day. And they see, did I meet my goal? Then they have their online learning programs, which are adaptive. So we meet the needs where the students are. We get to see what kids know, how much time are they spending, and how much additional instruction do they need. For example, Vanessa. What is she struggling on, and then providing that individual instruction?
Ms. Bickel is teaching us to read because when we grow up, we should already know how to read books and how to write, because in college, they're going to give us a lot of papers that we have to write.
She accomplishes her goals every week, so it's not just teacher, but it's also very student-driven. And that's why she's reading in second grade reading level in first grade. Ultimately, school should be a place of joy, should be a place of also challenge at the same time, because challenges help you grow when they're the correct challenges. And this model works because it's for the kids. I think that if I can give a smaller child the power to read, that I've done something right.